Looks like the primary coupling has been destroyed, so attaching the arm will be a problem. Lots of other dents and scratches. I think repairing this worker bee is going to be a bit more work intensive than I thought. Primarily the worker bee is reinforced with the hardest hull type we had access to, because it should stand up to a lot of punishment, but I don't think it's going to be maintainable in a situation as this. Fortunately I have some materials running already. So I've got some hull running, and just to match it up, I've got some lucra here to create yellow paint. So what I'm thinking of doing is basically replace all the expensive hull with cheaper ones, and then repair the whole worker bee. Then we can use it for our future mining expeditions. So we'll let this run for a bit, and then we'll get back once we got the basic materials done. Grey hull. Let's add some factory enhancers to speed up the process. It's a bit of a long wait to do it one at a time at the moment. I think I'll add them here at the bottom, just for now. I think we have enough power to get 5 at least running. So if we connect this one to all the factory enhancers here, like this, this should speed up the process a whole lot. Yeah, that's better. I think this will be enough paint for now. Let's create some yellow hull instead. Let's see, yellow hull. That should do it. We'll go with 100 for now. Not 1000, 100. Yeah, that is working. Let it run for a bit, and then we only need, I think, some lights and perhaps some black hull if I can create a paint for it. And that's done. So I'll take this. Let me check if we can create some black hull now. Let's see, what do we need for black paint? Black paint. We'll be needing tacked capsules. Do we have tacked? Not sure. Dolem. I don't think we do. So instead, I think I will create some dark gray hull as a replacement. And we'll use that instead. Dark gray hull. What do we need for that? We need some crystal and alloyed mesh. Still have some. Let's go for 200 for now. And 200 of these. It should do. And yeah, it's running again. So we'll go with that, and that should be it for the worker bee, I think, to replace all the hardened hull. And that's done as well. There's one more thing I need, I think. It's some lights and perhaps some green hull to replace the green normal hull over there. But again, I'm not sure if I got... Well, perhaps Faris will do the trick. Let's grab 10 of those. And do we need anything else? I don't think we do. Because for lights we just need glass and then the light rods. And then we can create lamps. So let's do that. And then we can start on converting the workable. And the lights are done. That should be it for the materials I need. Created some green hull as well. And some different shapes I needed. So I think I'm all set to replace everything. Let's get to that. Okay, I think we're done for now. We've replaced all the advanced hull with the regular hull. So this workable will be a lot easier to maintain, a lot cheaper at least. So I think I can take this out and now to mine some more resources.
Inefficient.
What do you mean inefficient?
Assuming direct control.
I think I see where you're going with this. Adding it to a fleet and letting it do the mining for me. Yes, I see now. So if I give this an order, this worker bee can mine for me. Okay, Claudius. Save this worker bee as a template in my library. We'll use it for later. We add a lot more worker bees to this fleet. We'll get a lot more resources going.
Template saved.
Let's test it out for a bit and see if it works. Let's mine in this sector. Okay, there it goes. Isn't reacting the way I thought it would be.
This worker bee has the processor capacity of a peanut.
Okay, yeah, it's not the smartest ship around, but there it goes. Just let it do its work. Okay, now that I've got the worker bee on automatic mining, I jumped into build mode because it gave me an idea for basically this smaller asteroid that we've got here. Now that we've got the automation going, I want to build a docking station or a offloading station for the worker bees that they can dock to the station, then offload their cargo and go out again to continue mining. I was thinking of doing that here, and I'm thinking about building some sort of area over here all the way through the asteroid to the other side, so they can enter from one side, undock the stuff in the middle, and then exit on the other side, and perhaps either park or do something else like mining again. The initial area I'm going to work with is, I think, a 9x9 area. Let's see how that works out. 9x9x9 then. Let's see, remove it just about here, I think. So let's continue to the other side. See how much space we've got to work with. A lot of space by the looks of it. And like this. So we've got this docking area over here. They can fly in the middle, then undock. Yeah, something like that. And I think on the sides we will create some sort of storage area that will allow the off-duct or the offloaded cargo to be destored for processing later. I think we'll go with that. Let me work a bit on it off camera and then we'll be right back with some more results. So this is the basic tunnel I created. Just some reinforcements in the walls and some lights to see what you're doing. But to make it actually work, I need some rails. And I checked, I don't have the materials for that yet, because the asteroids that contain these materials are most likely more into the inner system, because they're hot asteroids that I need. So I think I'll have to take out the worker bee myself and hunt them down, and then I can add a rail in this particular section to pull in the worker bees to get them in the offloading position. Okay, grab that worker bee again, at least I called it. B been using this ship core over here as the fleet mothership, because a fleet will not work with just one ship in it. So we'll take this worker bee deeper in system and look for some more asteroids that we need. So I think we'll just head this way and see what we can find. We're really close to the star now. I'm even surprised I haven't burned off my hull yet. But I think these are the asteroids we're looking for. So let me gather some resources and we'll see if we can create some more components. Oh, this is too close already. Like I said, really close to the star. Let's just grab the ones that are a bit further back. Well, as you can see, I have a little bit of engine trouble and power is not great. The mining beam is not constantly firing anymore. Yeah, I've took a bit of damage from the sun, so this worker bee is basically a goner. Whoops. Well, it's a cheap craft anyway, so I'll just craft a new one or repair this one if you really need it. But I did manage to find the materials that I needed. These crystals exactly are the ones that I need for the rails, as far as I know. So I'll just do the mining this way for now, and then continue with the project for the offloading of the worker bees, and just create a new one for general purposes mining after I've done that. So just heading back to base now, and we'll see what we do then. I'd like to say that it looks worse than it is, but it's worse. I think it's just pure luck that the core survived, but we've got the materials back to base, so we'll just refine them, and then I think I'll just scrap this and create a blueprint for a new one. We saved the template anyway for this this worker bee, so that shouldn't be a problem. Just let me get this loaded up, and we'll continue from there. If we are going to work with blueprints for the new worker bees, then we are going to need a shop module. So let's create one, and then we can buy some more blueprints to get the worker bees back in action. So yeah, the sinter crystals, that's the resource I was after. I can create rails with this, the regular rails, and then the new rail type that will allow ships to dock to another ship, to the mothership. And the core I've been using as the mothership for now, I think I'll dock that in the tunnel and see if I can make that work, so it will dock to the core and then shoot out or something to the station and dock over there. That's the experiment we're going to try. So I'm back in build mode. I've grabbed some of the different types of rails that I could craft with the materials I had, and I'm going to try to integrate that in the tunnel I have here over here. The first thing I want to try is, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we've got 6 sections, so the mill should be here. If we put a rail in here, let's see, I think we'll have to face it inward to the big asteroid, like this, this way. I'm going to dock the core and a single rail docker in the middle over here, and then I can build from that to allow the rails to extend outside of the tunnel. So let's try that. I've got a core stash over here. So take this one, and I have to put a rail docker on the bottom. So that's this one. Let's see, let's get it pointed the correct way. See it this way, yeah, like this. So we go to the menu, set this to 1, then we should be able to dock this within the station. Let's see, put it over here. Careful. Why is it not working? Cut the rail docker. Cut the rail. But it's not docking. Why not? No ID. Okay, this is a bit later now. I managed to dock the single core with the rail docker. Apparently, for some reason, the faction was reset on this structure, so I had to enter it again. So, if that ever happens to you, just re-enter your faction signature in the faction block, and that should fix the things. Okay, but I was trying to build something here, and what I want to do is, I think they should enter from that side. So if we grab these rails, and then we need the green ones. I think a worker bee is 5 by 5 by 5. So on this height they should dock. And if I grab the rails from here, I should get it all the way outside this tunnel. Something like this. And then, for example, the pickoff point will be here. So it's the blue one. So they will be recalled to this point, then they will dock here. And then I think they should shoot out. Yeah, like that. And then I'll build a pickup point on the structure of the station itself, so I have to return to the build block for that. I'll do that and then I'll be right back. Enter back in build mode again. I did grab some additional blocks as well, because I need to build some sort of structure that the worker bee can rest on. So that will be something over here. We need a regular rail. Let's put it like this for now. And then we need a pickup point like this. I think this should work. I think we can test it out as well with the damaged worker bee we have. One thing I need to change with it, however, is the rail docker on this worker bee, because it's pointing the other direction than I want. So let's modify that. Yeah, it's pointing backwards, so we want to point it to the front. Yeah, we know. Ignore it. So we want to point it the other way. Let's see. That way. Yeah, like that. So if we fly with the rail dock selected, we can see the pickup points. We can fly it over here. And then it should pick up on its own, I hope. Yeah, there it goes. Yeah, it's moving along the line. And if it gets to the end, it will be shooting out to the rail docker of the station and hopefully be picked up immediately. Let's see. No, it's not. So I placed another build block here because I was getting tired of getting back in front to the vector section in here. So I shorted the pickup rail and then placed the pickup point here on the station on top of this rail block. Let's test it out if this works better or not. So we'll need the worker bee again and we'll see if this works out better than the last attempt. I'm hoping at least. Let's see, where is the pickup point? Over here. So it needs to dock. There it goes. So it will reach the end of the pickup rail a lot sooner. Shoot out. And it's not picked up. Okay, this is my third attempt. I undocked the core and rail docker, then added a rail on top of it. Let's see what it does if it's in on the undocked entity. And I should be able to dock here. Yes. Like this. And then it will shoot out, hopefully hitting this rail pickup. It's not. Okay, attempt number 4. I've added the rail pickup rails and then the pickup point here. Let's see if that works better. So let's dock again. Let's see what it does. Okay, approaching the exit rail. And fail again. Okay, another attempt. This time I've put a physical barrier inside the tunnel. See how it reacts to that. Because if it clips through the physical barrier as well, then we might have a problem with interacting entities with the station. Okay, it does stop it. So, and it picks up on the rail. Okay, it works, sort of, but it should still need a lot of tweaking before I would call this a very functional system, but we've got a start. The next functional step would be connecting this docking system to some sort of storage area over there, and then offload the cargo this worker bee has and process it from there. But that's for next time.